Running an inventory count for your store in Korona is simple and can be done in a few quick steps. Whether you want to count your entire store, a certain product, or identify irregularities, Korona can do it. There are four different types of inventory counts. For this video, we will be talking about inventory sampling. Inventory sampling allows you to count specific products, assortments, or groups. Navigate to the Inventory tab and click on Inventories. Create a new one, name it, and choose the inventory sampling procedure. You can also choose a start date and whether or not you want to automatically book or finalize the inventory count after a set amount of days. Choose the organizational units that you want to count. If you choose more than one, a list will be created for each unit. Finally, save. After you save, an inventory count list will be created. Click on it and then edit inventory count list. You will now choose the products you want to count. You can do this several different ways. Click Add Product. The default source is product, which means you can simply start typing the name or number of a product, then add it. Alternatively, you can change the source to assortment, commodity group, supplier, or tag. These options will add every product in that particular source. You can also add products by scanning them. Click on Scan Products and start scanning. If you scan the same barcode more than once, the number of scans will be shown in the actual goods column when you are finished. After adding the products you wish to count, you have the option to start entering the actual goods counted, or you can show nominal goods. The nominal goods number is how many of each particular item that Korona expects you to have. This number will reflect what is currently on hand when the inventory count list is loaded, not when it is created. If a product on your list was sold after creating the list, simply hit back and reload the list. The nominal goods will reflect that item no longer being on hand. This list can be exported in PDF or Excel spreadsheet format, allowing you to print them off for your employees. You can also alter the average purchase price during the inventory procedure. Enter in the number of actual goods that you counted, save, and then book. A window will pop up asking you to validate your inventory count. Any item that has a difference between the nominal goods and the counted value will display, allowing you to confirm the count. In addition, any item that has a blank in the actual goods column will display. Choose actions for missing entries, and you can decide what you would like to do with these, either removing the item from inventory, setting the actual goods to zero, or setting the actual goods to match the nominal goods. Counting your inventory from the point of sale is just as easy. Make sure you have a blank receipt open and start adding items to the receipt. Once you have counted what you want, use the function Inventory Receipt. You should now have a new inventory sampling count sheet ready to be booked. The quantity of items posted is automatically entered in the actual stock, and the inventory can be posted immediately.